Continuity demands linkage, so we start our story by taking you back to a year ago. The American wearing this beautiful garland and holding a trophy is William Elliston, moments after emerging as the 2005 annual cross-country cycle champion. In the 78th edition of this Holy Saturday Classic, Elliston hopes to become only the second American to win two titles and in back-to-back fashion at that, a la Chris Harkis style of 2003-2004. At the 6 a.m. start, nevertheless, Belizeans are focused on the rising star of Marlon Castillo, praying this local product could bring back the title to the homeland, missing in action since the year 2002. In fact, 96 Belizeans are suited up against 24 foreigners who have claimed 8 of the last 10 championships, conceding only 2 to Ernest Main, one in 1997, the other in 2001. Kindly note these two riders in front of the peloton at the start. They're the ones to watch, which begs the question, does greatness follow the script all the time? And 120 riders begin the quest for Holy Saturday glory. They will travel a total of 140 miles from Belize City to San Ignacio and back for the finish inside the Marion Jones Sporting Complex. Of course, destiny sometimes has its own ideas, and the victims of the variables in cycling would certainly wish they were not caught up in this major spill less than 5 miles into the 2006 race. Meet Adriano Campo of Team Cancun, hailing from Mexico, after executing the breakout outside of Hattieville on his way to the $1,000 prize at mile 24 going. Fortunately or unfortunately, the Mexican Campo finds himself with a back wheel puncture, which automatically leads to a change in the front of the race. Around mile 35, we now have a six-man lead. Peter Choto and Ron Vasquez of Cayo, two megabyte riders, Darnell Barrow and Byron Pope, Sherman Thomas of Belmopan, and Carlos Gabriel Hernandez of Team Guatemala. Through the Roaring Creek area, this uneasy alliance between six Belizean junior riders and the visiting Guatemalan begins to show sign of strain, especially after Darnell Barrow grabs 3 station prizes in a row. Excited to be on his training grounds, Peter Choto of Cayo loses focus, people, and falls unaided. This certainly hurts his game. Next of all is Sherman Thomas, and on this wet asphalt, slip is a go. Thomas would nevertheless return. By the time the race arrives at Mount Hope, it's a new configuration with Giovanni Choto, Jose Choto, Peter Choto, Ron Vasquez, Darnell Barrow, and Guatemalan Carlos Hernandez. At the halfway mark, it's Jose Choto grabbing the win in 2 hours, 40 minutes, 39 seconds, followed by the Guatemalan as the lead four swings back to head the other way. Needless to say, the chase group is only 3 minutes away, which must be manageable from their perspective. Through Roaring Creek, the lead four remains in control of the pace. However, at mile 35, the re-amalgamation occurs, and now we have a brand new ball game on its way to Belize City. A new Guatemalan steps up in the person of Juan Carlos Hernandez and tries to run all the way to term. But Shane Vasquez decides to put it all into this move and streaks away from the chase pack. Here is Shane Vasquez overtaking Hernandez at mile 20 without even looking for help. At Hattieville, it's still Shane Vasquez of Western Spirit in time trial mode. At mile 8, we can see that this Cayo rider intends to run all the way to the finish line. The run holds up all the way to the track, people, and the hometown crowd applauds the appearance of this Belizean rider. However, it's not over till it's over. Luis Santiso, Jose Robles, and Giovanni Choto enter the park with Shane boasting just a half a lap lead in a 2-lap race. Folks, today it's a perfect game plan being executed. Shane Vasquez hooks the final curve, and now he knows the hard work has certainly paid off. He raises his arms in victory, and the crowd roars. It's been a long time coming indeed. Meanwhile, the race for second place finds Jose Robles of Mexico riding for Guinness Seahawks, zipping past Luis Santiso, the Guatemalan rider for M&M Engineering, who finishes third, while 17-year-old Giovanni Choto of Cayo, he pulls up fourth. Anthony Taylor, Jamaican riding for Malik's, blasts the crowd for fifth place. Gregory Lovell, he pulls up sixth. Ian Smith settles for seventh. Leslie Sanchez takes eighth place for a second year in a row. Jesus Hernandez of Yucatan, he takes ninth place, while Dwight Lopez rounds out the top 10. Belizeans, today a prince becomes a king, and Shane Vasquez, the new champion, uses the sub Umbra Florio to give respect to the many fans who prayed for a Belizean to take back the title this year.
Well, I have coming into the last like 30, 20 miles into Belize City, I look around at the field and I said, but why do I have all these strength just sitting in the race all the way going up, all the way coming back? So I said, like, let me go out and see what I could do, you know? If the field want to be there with me, they will chase me, but they really had to chase. I tried my best and I went out for it. I went out all out and thanks to the support of the Belizean people who have really cheered me on to help motivate me to win this race to get today.
I kept saying your best chance to win a cross country was exactly what you did, running away and avoiding the sprint.
Well, I know I'm not that of a great sprinter, so I had to go out on my own, you know, and try to lead the sprinter on the road. I know if it would have come down on a sprint, then there's a least likely chance that I would have won the race, so I had to do it on a solo move, which I did today.
We asked fourth place finisher Giovanni Toto if his attempts at the station prizes going into San Ignacio affected his overall finish.
Yeah, it affected, but I want to secure something, Toto. I never made too sure about it.
This kind of a success at this age is certainly unbelievable.
Well, I want to win a cross country too, and I hope so I get it someday.
We rode 70 kilometers, but it was very difficult because we experienced many spills. Some of the guys even got badly hurt, while others just rode off the road. I'm glad nothing worse happened, considering the lesson I learned a year ago.
There was a lot of counterattacks, and we tried to cover it. We did manage to have a split. However, what's his name?
Shane
Vasquez. He took off, and everyone was riding tempo. It seems like no one really wanted to catch him, which is fine because he's Belizean. That's great, you know.
So can I ask you why didn't you go and?
Well, because we did all the chasing all day. We were wasted. It was only three of us and two left. So you know what we do? Just chase and let everybody sit on. They were counterattacking us. As soon as we chase, they counterattack. We chase all day.
Tony, it's a way of riding. If you were carrying the jersey of the defending champion, so you had to be followed all day. But what about the Guatemalan escape from you after that?
The Guatemalan escape, we let him slide because we know that, you know, if we went after him, everybody would come. So we try to keep the race calm by letting him go up the street. You know what I mean? It was a strategy we used. Just let him go, and then he'll keep everything calm so that we would at least get a rest.
Leslie Sanchez, riding for Comfort Air, finished eighth for a second year in a row.
Well, actually, around mile 21, that was where the breakaway went. My teammate, Quinton Hamilton, had attacked. He attacked to get cross, and while he was chasing, they brought him back, and I counter off his attack and went cross to the breakaway.
For the defending champion going in, a year made a world of difference.
And the plans definitely changed a bit, obviously, once they realized I was out of it. I think it kind of freed both Tony and Stefan up a little more to kind of follow some moves and try and initiate some moves to get a group clear. And that's what they tried to do. And they both made the big chase group coming in behind Shane. And, you know, I was listening to the radio on the way in the truck, and you know, I know it sounded like Stefan was trying to attack quite a bit to get away, and sounded also like he was a pretty marked man. So that's the unfortunate distinction we have, as being pretty well marked.
That's the life of a champion. I want to ask you also, Bill, you might not be able to come back to Belize to ride this particular race. However, the M&M Tour rules does allow you to come back. Will we be seeing a return of Bill Elliston to Belize?
If the M&M Tour kind of reaches their goal of a UCI sanctioned event, I'll come back. Otherwise, I don't know that I'd come back for it, because there's just been a lot of headache dealing with getting me entered in the event this year, despite, you know, that I'm still technically an amateur. and it just caused a lot of confusion, and I'm not necessarily sure I want to deal with some of that political stuff again. So if the tour gains the UCI status, I'd love to come back, because it's a great race. Otherwise, I can't really see myself coming back for that.
And so, Belizeans, we might have seen the last of Bill Elliston. Nevertheless, folks, 2006 certainly belongs to Shane Vasquez and the Western Spirit Cycle team. Congratulations, guys. You've made Belize big time proud. And as we leave you with this image of Shane Vasquez receiving his bull, undeservedly so, we want to say thank you to Kwame Scott for his assistance in this 2006 Cross Country Classic. I'm James Adderley, reporting for News 5.
Get the cyclist.
Please.
Justin, is everybody just in front of you? When the race is going, nobody is just in front of you again. You know, 1 hour.
Mike!
Champion,
let's go see it.
So come and step forward in front of the race. Mr. Marlon Castillo. And I'd like to present the defending cross country champion, Mr. William Elliston. Gentlemen, respect the officials, respect the rules. May you all have good strength, good stamina, and good speed. May it be a safe race, and at the end, May the best man win. We have 4 minutes.
What's up?
Get him, boy, get him, get him, get him.
Junior. Yeah, Junior, right, right, right.
Daniel and Pope.
Steady, let's go. You can do it. You can do it. Don't give up. You can do it.
Let's go, Pop. Jojo. Let's go, Byron!
3 minutes of their work.
Let's go, man. No, man, Pate.
Aguate, Kiara, aguate.
Let's go, Buta.
Don't follow me, boy. Don't follow me.
Let's go, Frank.
still not do nothing. I beat all of them. Every single one.
Hey, respect to Kenneth Butler coming in big time with the Indian Cup.
James.
He's not in the runnings, but now we join Quark.
Yeah, the next mic, Alex.
Can I get it to Zombie Park? Jim?
Walk me through what happened after the break. We was established somewhere around, I'd say, mile 20 or so, when you all about 15 to 20 guys got away.
There was a lot of counter attacks, and we tried to cover it. We did manage to have a split. However, what's his name?
Shane
Vasquez. He took off, and everyone was riding tempo. Seems like no one really wanted to catch him, which is fine because he's Belizean. That's great, you know?
So can I ask you, why didn't you go and...
Well, because we did all the chasing all day. We were wasted. It was only three of us and two left. So, you know, what we do? Just chase and let everybody sit on. They were counter-attacking us. As soon as we chase, they counter-attack. We chase all day.
Tony, it's a way of riding. If you were carrying the jersey of the defending champion, so you had to be followed all day. But what about the Guatemalan escape from you after that?
The Guatemalan escape, we let him slide because we know that, you know, if we went after him, everybody would come. So we try to keep the race calm by letting him go up the street. You know what I mean? It was a strategy we used. Just let him go, and then you'll keep everything calm so that we would at least get a rest.
Finally, what happened on the sprint?
I'm not sure. I was feeling very, very strong for the sprint. I attacked many times coming in, and they just counterattack and sit up. Robles was unfortunate. He counterattacked after I went, and he got away. Everybody was watching me, so that's it.
So he and the other fellow got away.
Yeah, but I was very strong for the sprint. I don't think anyone could take me in the sprint today.
I saw that, and I've known it to be a sprinter, but this is the first time I've seen in front of the big Belizean crowd doing your thing.
Well, you know, I prepared for this race. I came here to win. I didn't come here to lose. I came to win.
Tony, finally, Bill might not be able to ride in the cross country again because of his status, probably.
Yeah.
What's next for Tony Taylor and cycling as far as Belize go?
I'm not sure yet. I'm not sure. We're gonna go back and think of.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to see a prince become a king. You, in 2004, you gave the world notice that you were serious about being the best you can be. Today, you picked your strategy and it came to fruition. And man, are you one great Belizean figure after this?
Well, that won't be possible without the support of the Western Spirit Cycling Team, our sponsor, Shapri, Safe Tour Belize. You got a Aramaca Resort in Placencia, Gearwood Companies. You got also the. Anyways, the team we have set up a really good service crew, and a race cannot be won without a good service crew. We have set up I have put together a really good crew today, two good Guatemalans and four strong Belizeans, three runners, Teddy, Ron, myself, which were brother, and Gian, our friend. And these guys have really done a tremendous work for the team today. And we have worked. My little brother was out there all day slaving himself, and I really appreciate what he has done for me. And we pulled out our strategy have really worked well throughout this race.
Before I ask you the next question, I must say I'm impressed with the genes in your family. Ron was pretty impressive this morning. However, more importantly, Shane, I know you made a great move. I think it was around mile 20, 24. You made a wonderful move.
You want to tell us about it, because that was the winning move.
Well, I have coming into the last like 30, 20 miles into Felicity, I look from the field and I said, but why do I have all these strength just sitting in the race all the way going up, all the way coming back? So I said, like, let me go out and see what I could do, you know? If the people want to be there with me, they will chase me, but they really had to chase. I tried my best and I went out for it. I went out a long time. And thanks to the support of the police and people who have really cheered me on to help motivate me to win this race today.
I kept saying your best chance to win across country was exactly what you did, running away and avoiding the sprint.
Well, I know I'm not that of a great sprinter, so I had to go out on my own, you know, and try to lead the sprinter on the road. I know if it would have come down on a sprint, then there's a least likely chance that I would have won the race, so I had to do it on a solo move, which I did today.
So what does this mean then for Jane Vasquez? You've stepped up to the big time?
Well, indeed, in the next 2 weeks I'll be going to Guatemala. Salvador to race along with the Guatemalan team in the Tour of Salvador 2 weeks from now, and hopefully we want to see if we could get Belizean cycling to be promoted internationally, which will go our best outside too.
Okay, you have a final word to the fan, because this must be a victory you are savoring. It's been a long time coming.
Well, I would like to say thanks to you all, the Belizean people. You have really cheered me on today. You have really motivated me today. Without you all, I cannot do it. Thanks.
Okay, you did not break the record, but good show nevertheless.
Well, hopefully first we'll schedule that some years down the road to go out and break that record. Pretty much we just wanted Belize to win today. Thanks.
Enjoy, Shane. But up at San Ignacio, making some big time moves. Do you think that affected your fourth place finish?
Yeah, it affected, but I know I secured something total. I know I'm not too sure about it.
What was the game plan for your team? Who you rode for this morning?
We made a ride for me and Raja mostly.
Your team?
For me and Raja, we made a ride like me and Raja made for sitting lap, but then I fell down early. So then I say I don't chase long, so my best thing I try go for some prizing.
How did this still make you feel not too far outside a car where you need to do your best?
Yeah, I feel strong.
Okay, you recovered in time. Tell us, what was your strategy coming down to Belize City when you saw we had a four-man breakaway, that change up, then you joined up back with the crowd?
I made a try hard, man. And I trained long for the race, and I thank God for giving me strength, and thanks to the team for helping me so much.
Tell the Belizean nation who you are.
I'm 17 years old.
And you have already finished 14th. How far do you think you'll be able to go as a cyclist? I mean, this kind of a success at this age is certainly unbelievable.
Well, why I want to do that, win a cross country too. I hope so, I get it someday.
How far are we away from that?
I don't really know.
You know, I certainly am marveling at your humility. Don't change, because you have brought a fresh breath of air to cycling, and you have brought certainly a whole lot of skills, and I know we'll hear from you later on down the road.
Yeah.
Anybody want to?
I thank the team and Sajitone and Zabaniden for supporting me so much, and my brother Adam for keep me the chain hard, man.
Giovanni, thanks for speaking to us.
Thanks.
Lester Sanchez, formerly of Northside Lounge, but more of Team Comfort Air. 8th place, 2 years in a row, Leslie. Tell me about it.
Well, actually last year I placed 8th, and this year I'm 8th place again, so I don't know if that's the lucky number, but I placed 8th again, man.
Leslie, tell me how you read the race, because there were early breakaways and you weren't involved. No one from your team was involved. When that real breakaway was initiated somewhere along, I think, mile 20, so how did you get to be a part of that?
Well, actually, around mile 21, that was where the breakaway went. My teammate, Quinton Hamilton, had attacked it. He attacked to get across, and while he was chasing, they brought him back, and I come to off his attack and went across to the breakaway.
After that breakaway was established and Shane broke out, what was your mindset? Didn't you want to go with Shane, or did you decide that, figure that you could sit back and wait and try to catch Shane so you could get the free ride?
Well, actually, I was Well, actually, I was trying to gamble, you know, I'm going to try gamble because I said, well, they are bringing Mark Sheen or you know, we got a lot of foreigners in our Breakaway with the course, so I said, well, they just may work together, and, you know, so I just really try to sit down, but down the stretch, I start to attack and thing, and really try to get quiet. Man.
After Sheen escaped, Guatemala escaped a little sometime after that, too, after my 10 headed towards Belize City. How were you apart of that?
Well, like what I said before, I was just trying to gamble and I was depending on other riders to put me there.
So what were you thinking about? What was Lester Sanchez thinking about when you entered the track with that group of star players, knowing that your best trait is not sprinting?
Well, I ain't that type of good sprinter, right? But I was just sitting in trying to like get the job from the other guys and was trying to do good like that just by using the other guys' wheels because I know there was some stronger guys than me up front there.
Finally, I'll give you this opportunity to tell me about the Comfort Air Northside Laundromat team.
Well, the Comfort Air Northside Laundromat is currently managed by Mr. Alvin Kahn and Ms. Debbie Vasquez. She was the one who took me out of the cold when nobody wasn't looking at me as a really dominant rider out here. You know?
So what's next for Leslie?
Well, I will try to train harder so that next year I can ride a better race and hoping that my teammates is ready too. Namely, Orlando Chavarria and Quinton Hamilton.
And you were also assisted by a foreigner today, right?
Yeah, but there was a lot of spills and he got into those spills. I actually got into like two spills, actually two, so today was a very rough race.
Leslie Cut.
TV Nacional. Okay. Estamos con José Robles, un buen atleta de México. Cada vez que vienes a Belice, tú eres un hombre peligroso. Hoy no era diferente.
Bueno, Dios, gracias a ti, a todos aquí en Belice, a mi sponsor, Guinness, un saludo muy especial. Y bueno, siempre trato de prepararme lo mejor que yo pueda. Y bueno, estos son los resultados, ¿no?
He says that he's very happy to be here. He loves the support of the people. He wants to thank Guinness Smiling for being his sponsor. And he says whenever he comes to Belize, he does the best that he can do. Hola, ¿cuál era el momento cuando tú decides a mover al frente?
Los últimos 70 kilómetros, pero fue difícil porque hubo muchas caídas y nos caímos muchos muchachos, unos muy mal, otros solo contra el fuera de la carretera, pero gracias a Dios no pasó nada porque después les traigo una lesión de hace un año aquí en Belice.
Ok, tú eras en ese accidente horrible en la última carrera y el Taya Nación dice que estamos siendo por ese incidente, pero hoy tú mueves bueno, tú estás recuperado, todo.
Sí, gracias a Dios y al apoyo que me dio Guinness y a lo mismo de Andrew Smiling, gracias a ellos, a los patrocinadores que apoyaron que la lesión fuera rápida, fue rápido el trabajo y gracias a mi Dios, aquí me tienen y me despido con un buen amigo para ustedes del ciclismo. Yo me retiro al ciclismo y quería ganar para ustedes.
Mi última pregunta, el segundo que tienes en esta carretera, ¿estás satisfecho?
Bueno, el primero es lo mejor, pero se trabajó bien, las cosas no se dieron, pero de todo lo difícil que fue la carrera, salimos bien, gracias a Dios. Un segundo lugar no es malo, quería ganar para Guinness, y no se pudo, así que un saludo muy especial y bueno, un saludo para ti y para todos, un saludo muy especial.
Country champion, Bill Elliston, he might not be a happy trooper right now, but Bill, first of all, I got to give kudos for Team Malik because you were three men strong and you all did a whole lot of chasing earlier. Were you worried about the final outcome when you were chasing? I mean, worried about you might not have the legs under you after that kind of chase? You guys were 5 minutes plus done.
No, I wasn't worried because, I mean, you know, once you turn in Kaio to head back, you have that headwind. and that really saps the guys out and that are out in front, especially when they've been out there for as long as they had been on the run in Ducayo. So, you know, 5 minutes, 7 minutes, I knew it was going to come down. We were chasing hard, but not, I mean, none of the three of us were nearly in our red zone, so we had plenty of energy in the tank, and we were totally confident that the outcome would still suit us.
Coming into the race, I would want to imagine that your guys would be here to protect you as the defending champion. After your unfortunate spill, did the plans change?
Yeah, I mean, the plans definitely changed a bit, obviously, once they realized I was out of it. I think it kind of freed both Tony and Stefan up a little more to kind of follow some moves and try and initiate some moves to get a group clear, and that's what they tried to do, and they both made the big chase group coming in behind Shane. And, you know, I was listening to the radio on the way in the truck, and, you know, I know it sounded like Stefan was trying to attack quite a bit to get away, and sounded also like he was a pretty marked man, so that's the unfortunate distinction we have, is being pretty well marked.
That's the life of a champion. I want to ask you also, Bill, you might not be able to come back to Belize to ride this particular race. However, the M&M Tour rules does allow you to come back. Will we be seeing a return of Bill Elliston to Belize?
If the M&M Tour kind of reaches their goal of a UCI-sanctioned event, I'll come back. Otherwise, I don't know that I'd come back for it, because there's just been a lot of headache dealing with getting me entered in the event this year, despite, you know, that I'm still technically an amateur. And it just caused a lot of confusion, and I'm not necessarily sure I want to deal with some of that political stuff again. So if the tour gains the UCI status, I'd love to come back, because it's a great race. Otherwise, I can't really see myself coming back for that.
Come on, I want to take this for my son.
Thank you. Olympics in New York to participate in the Father's Day race to the first Belizean company, donated by Denise and Erwin Burgess. It's won by Shane Watson.
Please bring in the trailer. Park the limousine.
Malik Sports, that is correct.
Put up the two of their shoes.
No hay para veteranos. El año pasado dieron para veteranos.
¡Ey, cuate!
¡No más tarde!
Hey, Meliwa, pick it up, Shane, pick it up! Pick it, help him, please, somebody! Yes, yeah, snap it up, snap it up! Yeah! The government is by Belize.